we can see it have fluctuation, it have variation. It is 324 volts. Now check voltage at VCC capacitor 10.55. before that here was fluctuation. Friends, welcome to Haseeb Electronics. Today I have this power supply. It have problem, it have no output and the output is fluctuating. Now we will apply power, and if you don't have a good knowledge how to deal with power electronics, how to deal with live voltage, never try to repair at yourself. And if you want to apply power, always use isolation transformer for your personal safety and equipment safety. So let's start. First of all, I will discuss the circuit. We have both lines, entering line and neutral. The neutral line, neutral is connected in this way. This is our neutral line, and phase is connected here, and there is one component that is fuse, this one, red fuse. And after passing fuse, there is one component NTC. So live or line voltage will pass from fuse from first safety, and then there is NTC for current limiting to protect from inrush current. And then we have a capacitor here, yellow capacitor. Then we have dual line filter, then we have capacitor. So it is our noise removal for prevention of electromagnetic induction. After that, we have two capacitors for common mode noise removal. So common mode and differential mode, both noises are removed. We have bridge rectifier, four diodes here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and these four diodes will rectify the AC voltage directly, and we will get rectified voltage on this capacitor, main capacitor. Then we have so this SMPS controller is connected here. We have one resistor here, this resistor for soft start voltage, this one. It is used, it is connected to VCC pin. VCC capacitor is here at this point, this capacitor. So it will charge the capacitor, and we will take voltage for VCC pin here. Feedback pin is number 2, and it is STR voltage at this point. This is drive pin. Now I will power on. To test any SMPS circuit, any power supply circuit, you have to take special care, because this side, live side, hot side, never touch any component to hot side. And we have some test points, and we will check them. Set multimeter to AC voltage to troubleshoot AC line. From this point, at this point, I have 229 volt AC. This is input inside a fuse. Check out outside a fuse. So fuse is working. If we have voltage at input side and output side, that means it's okay. Check this point for the NTC and output of NTC. If we have a voltage at input and if we have voltage at output, that means our this component is good. Then here, this line is coming directly here. At this point we have voltage. Check the output of the inductor of this filter, dual line filter, we have voltage. Now this is input of the bridge, we have voltage 229. So that means our this section is good. if there is disconnection, suppose we have voltage here, we don't find voltage here, that means this component is disconnected. If our fuse is burning again and again, that means we have short circuit from this point. In this area we have short circuit. If the fuse is burning again and again, then that time we have some short circuit. Now set multimeter to DC, check voltage, DC voltage at main capacitor. We can see it have fluctuation, it have variation. Why this is variation? We have to troubleshoot. Where is the problem? Now check this voltage at VCC capacitor. Here is VCC capacitor at this point. We have a big variation at VCC pin. Now we have to check the switching. Set multimeter to AC. Connect. This line is connected directly. Capacitor positive terminal is connected to primary, and second end of winding is connected to this IC, this driver. So we will check the drive at drive voltage at transformer primary. Fluctuating voltage, why? Because the SMPS controller is going on, off, start, restart. Why? There is something wrong in the output section. How we can detect? Set multimeter to DC. We can check the output of optocoupler. That means it is finding something wrong. At input of the optocoupler, pin 1 and 2, we have fluctuation here. Now we can check the output, ground, and check output. We have output, but it is fluctuating. So that means there is something short circuit in the output area. When any component will get short circuit, there will excessive current flow in the secondary of the winding of the transformer. When there is excessive current flow, this flow will cause to generate excessive VCC voltage due to reverse EMF, and it will also missing feedback because the voltage will not be stable in the input side. When input side is not good, it will disable the IC. When it will disable, at that time the VCC voltage in the auxiliary winding will stop, IC will stop functioning. At that time the recovery voltage at the VCC capacitor will reach again. So and the IC will go in a restart mode. When it will restart, it will make a burst. When it will make a burst, we will find another time voltage in the output, and when it will detect feedback, short circuit due to missing feedback and over voltage and VCC pin, it will go in disable state, restart, start, restart, start, restart, disable, start, restart, disable, start, restart. This action will keep continue. So now I will disconnect power, and we will detect the output area. What is the short circuit here? First of all, we have to test the rectifiers. Set multimeter to test diodes, diode function. Now connect to one diode. In one way it is charging the Schottky rectifier. It is, we can say this diode, if you connect a multimeter across the diode, it is charging. That means the diode is reverse biased, but we are charging the capacitor through the transformer winding. Now reverse the leads, 0.164, that means the diode is good. Now connect to second diode, it is giving short circuit. Reverse the leads, we are finding the same short circuit. That means this diode is suspected. check the second diode here. Inside there is another diode. So this diode is good. Oh wow. Check, this diode is 003. So this diode have some different reading. Again check behavior of this diode. It's good. Why? Because it is stopping from one side. The other side it is stable at 0.164. It's good. But this diode 0.055, this diode have both sides same resistance. This diode from one side it is 1.027, reverse the leads. It is 0.480, that means this diode is good. Now we have to check this diode 003. It is totally short. So we have to check this one. Where is that? It's here. We have to remove. I disconnected from the circuit. Wow. So no need to reverse the leads, but so this diode is bad. We have to replace this diode. First I will check without this diode and then we will check DC voltage. It is 324 volt. Now check voltage at VCC pin, VCC capacitor 10.55. before that here was fluctuation. Now these voltage are stable. Check the output of the feedback optocoupler, 1 volt, that's okay. Check input side, okay. And check the outputs. We have still missing this output. Why it is missing, we have to check it. This voltage 4.4 volt. It is 12 volts. First I tested without this diode. Now I installed another diode in replacement of this bad diode, this short circuit diode. So now we will check the inputs. Power is applied, take care. It is 323 volts. Voltage are stable. Check voltage at capacitor, that is stable. Now check the VCC pin, that's okay. Input side okay. Check the outputs here. ...3.9 ...4.6, ground line, 12 volt, 23 volt, 12, 23. So our this section was short, this section short, and this shortage made problem for everything. So now we have another very small issue. I will remove power and I will show you what is the problem. We have dry soldering here. Here is some dry joints. So we have to touch the soldering again and then we will check check back. Never touch any board when it is live. 4.6, 3.9, okay. So our this power supply is now recovered. We found this diode short, replaced it. If this video is good for you, like, subscribe and share if you want. If you want to watch my future videos, you can press bell icon button. And now I will remove this diode and I will connect in proper way. So this video, this power supply is recovered. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.